The last time indie music darling Inchtra was on Razzie TV, she was 21 years old. 4 years on, she's had a YouTube show, performed multiple times in the United States, and is poised to release her sophomore album, Bumfuzzle. Streamlining her stage name to just Inch, and with a new look becoming of a rock star, I ask Inch what would happen if she met her younger self.
I think the old me would have yelled at me and said I've sold out, but... I think because if I look back and who I was, that's what happens when you're young. You're so sure of what you want and what you have to say and what you believe in, which is great. But then again, you know little. You know very little. And as I get older, I realize the more I know, the more I don't know. And that's something that I definitely foresee my very myopic mentality as a kid to tell me right now, because I would have like a much smaller worldview back then than I do today. And I could travel back in time and tell something to me without terribly altering the force of the world and timeline. I would say spend more time with your family. Really, I would say spend more time with your family, because they would get really far and few in between. And don't forget your friends. Don't ever forget your friends, like who your friends are.
Looking back now at yourself in 2009 and yourself now, is this where you wanted to be? The way you look, the way the place in life you want to be, and obviously where the music is?
Yeah, I think over the years you try to develop as an artist, like you try to find what your sound is or what, and particularly your style that also translates into aesthetics as well. So, I've never was someone in the past that was really into fashion, because like, it just didn't speak to me. I was all about comfort and music is music, you know? But now it's different because I suddenly, the more other artists I've met, like they are like, fashion is like an extension of their music or who they are. And I've learned to appreciate that. And it's kind of like I started figuring out, yeah, what is my mission statement? And I should start dressing the way I feel and how it would reflect my music as well. So I wouldn't say I found it, I'm still just experimenting.
Looking to the next 4 years, she sees herself taking on producing and writing for other artists. And as a Singaporean female singer-songwriter, it's no surprise that Inch sometimes gets associated with veteran musician Tanya Chua.
Do people come to you and say, and sort of make this comparison to Tanya Chua?
Some people ask if I'm related just because we have the same last name, so yeah. There's some people, initially when you generally have, you're a female with an acoustic guitar on stage playing English originals, Singaporean, everyone kind of just relates to someone that has already kind of started a path in it, which is Tanya. And I think that's not that it's a bad thing, I don't see it as a bad thing at all, but what I do see what I wish is actually that there will be more women doing it, that we don't have to always compare to just a few individuals. That just the vibrancy of it just needs to go up, and there just needs to be more people just doing this.
Embracing technology and using it to her advantage, Inch funded her upcoming album, Bumfuzzle. Aiming for a $10,000 budget, she met the mark and got over $5,000 more. In the next part, she talks about being a musician in the internet age.